Now, first off, one of the quick upgrades that we can do to help improve this printer is by giving a little protection around the Z rods themselves. We're gonna put these little caps onto the top. It's also gonna give a little bit of a personal flair because you can kind of pick whatever color that you wanna go with. Most importantly, you'll be able to kind of protect the top of that area. Let's put them on, shall we? I did print three of these and they are in PLA, but you don't have to do PLA for this. You can do whatever you want. Probably should have done this in PETG just to give it a little bit more of a high temperature tolerance versus the PLA, since it will be inside an enclosed printer. It's super easy to install this. All we have to do is set it on top and push down and it's installed. And best of all, if you do want to switch this out or you need to remove it for any reason, little fingernail pops right off. Super easy. Next one is going to be along those similar lines of protecting the Z rod axes here. And that's with these little pieces that we printed right here that are going to go around and kind of help protect that bearing. And this will actually help prevent the rods picking up any debris. Now, as you can see, there is a bunch of debris in here. The idea of this is to help protect the bearings from getting messed up by any debris and whatnot. These install really easily, but it's just making it a little bit more difficult because I'm trying to film at the same time. And there we go. Now, I have checked these actually are the right profiles to where they don't actually hit the above bearings. And there are three of these rods that you want to protect. So we're going to try and get this one back here. Probably the hardest one to install. Now, I love the AMS, but it does have some downsides. You can't run TPU or any carbon fiber filled materials through it, which means you actually have to use the external spool holder that doesn't utilize the AMS. Now, the problem with that is the fact that it's on the back of the machine and it's kind of hard to get to. So what we're going to do today is we're actually going to install a side mounted spool holder, thanks to this free design that I found on MakerWorld. Using a 2mm Allen, we can remove these screws. Now, using the same screws, we can reinstall it. Make sure it's nice and tight. Now, we have a side-mounted spool holder. I did print this over in PETG High Flow from Bambu Lab, and I did that because I wanted it to be strong, but still temperature resistant. Does get hot in my garage with enough weight on it. I didn't want to break or droop for that matter. Hope this fits with the other printers like that, because that could be a problem. Ideally, I think I want to print these in something like nylon, for instance, but I don't really want to buy a whole roll of spool of nylon because chances are I probably might not use it. Now, this is where today's sponsor comes into play, PCBWay. Now, I could actually go onto PCBWay's website and actually order a couple of these for super cheap and actually get them fairly fast. And thanks to PCBWay, I don't actually have to worry about these printing properly or trying to reprint them. They're just gonna be right the first time. Real quick, PCBWay just doesn't do PCBs. They do 3D printing, metal 3D printing, sheet metal, and also CNC machining. I really can't wait to utilize their CNC machining here in the future for a future project. I just don't know what it's gonna be yet. Give me some ideas down in the comments below. Well, thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video. These machines are pretty notorious for leaving out lots of little poop out the back of the machine. And for those who don't know what this poop term means, is it's basically just all this filament that comes out the back of just wasted purge. Unfortunately, you can't really do anything with this poop, so it is kind of just waste, unfortunately. But since this is just shot out the back of the printer, it's called poop. And well, that's why we have a poop bucket. All right, so this next upgrade is a really cool poop bucket. It actually will use the existing screws on the printer to hold this. It's gonna give you a really small and thin way to have a poop bucket without taking up a ton of space. Now, to install this, it's pretty straightforward. Fortunately, this doesn't use the stock screws. I got some M3x8s, which I'm gonna use to hopefully get this to work. And now we have a very simple poop bucket, very thin, doesn't hold a ton of poop, but definitely does the job. So now this last one is gonna kind of add into adding a little bit of flair to the printer while also maybe adding a little bit of protection. This is a super cool little fan shroud that has the Transformer logo on it. And this is gonna go right over the fan for the print head. I'm not entirely 100% on how I feel about it adding protection, but stops you from sticking your finger in it, right? Let's get this installed, check it out, see how it looks. First off, I'm gonna need to lower the bed to make it a little easier to get to. Thankfully, I have the Big Tree Tech screen up here to make this a lot easier on the P1S. There we go. Clips in super easy. And now my P1S is a transformer. There you have it. There's 5 free files for your P1S. If I missed any, drop them down in the comments below and you might just see those in a future video. I'm super interested to see what you guys have to put down there. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you check out this one because YouTube thinks you're gonna like it.